7 years ago. Okay, so those who are here, how many of you remember Ms. Grimes? Remember Ms. Grimes? She was the theater teacher at the time. And 7 years to this week, it was on the 14th of April, because even before I started working here, Ms. Grimes, the theater teacher at the time, I was scheduled to come out for a visit to do a transition. And she sent me this PowerPoint and said, we'd like to let you know about our needs before you come. And the biggest need we saw at the time, we being the arts faculty, was we needed a theater. She said, at a minimum, we need a black box, which we have. Ideally, she said, we want a theater that can seat at least one whole school, or the whole school. And if you remember back then, the school was about 480 kids. She said, we want a stage with the lights and the sounds and the acoustics and the stage, stage shot and dressing rooms and storage. And by the way, can we have an art gallery too? And that vision, that request, while it took a very long time to get here, is what we realize today. From the teachers who cared so much about it and are for such a long time that it was a big part of the school. 2 years after that, we had our concept drawing. The concept drawing was basically an artist rendering of what it would look like. And the thing that always blows me away is this looks exactly like what the artist had drawn back then. The architect firm out of the United States had done theaters all around the world, and we contracted with somebody who was specialized in theaters. And this theater was conceptualized to be patterned after the one in Johannesburg, at the American School of Johannesburg. And so we went down there, we looked at it, the architect knew the project, we built that one, and we said, you know, we want this, this, and this, and we want it to do better than what Johannesburg had. That's why our gym is on the second floor, and the fitness rooms, the offices, and the classrooms are on the ground floor, because in Johannesburg, they put them side by side, and they're too small. After your concept drawing, you then start building, and we all know the story of the roofing, the delays, and the coronavirus, and everything else like that. But I cannot tell you, I literally, how sad I am tonight. This is our first time in front of students, in front of an audience. And I literally can't wait in about, 7 odd weeks, we'll hand you your diploma on this day.
lying on the couch, drinking a beer, chewing gum. No. Pop. So I said to him, I said, Bernie, you pop that gum one more time. And he did. So I took a shotgun off the wall. Fired two warning shots into his head.
Thank you.
You sure?
Yes.
All right, let's partake!
Your clothing. Let's just say I'm a little. Come on, let me see you get up. Bitch got something pregnant, it's a way too much. I tell the bitch to turn it off.
I like when you hide, find stuff they can hide.
say hello. The rich summer heat protects the white people. They're all smoking the same oregano. that's it. We never really do this. How do I do have much of us this week? No, no need for you to thank us.
this is the part that Miss Jen loves the most. It's our fourth year working together. Miss Jen came and she brought the Thespian troupe to ISD. The Arts of Crime over the past 7 years is part of this strategic plan. You see it in the theater before you, but it's people like Miss Jen who have brought the arts to life through the tireless work. The efforts that she did to bring this show to life this year with COVID in our background have been phenomenal. So this is a huge thank you to you for all you've done to make this happen.
Parents, could you please, you can exit at this time, please, and then we'll go to the staff, and then we'll go to the students.